Although North America had been settled for tens of thousands of years by people from Asia, it was virtually unknown to Europeans until the voyages of Christopher Columbus.
When Columbus sailed the ocean blue in 1492, what he thought that he was going to do was find a shortcut all the way to India. And when he landed over here, in his mind he was quite clear. He thought he knew exactly where he was. I mean, he thought he was in India.
He called the natives Indians. He was wrong, of course, but the name stuck.
About it in a book, take to the road and have a look, and you can find out what it took to make the map of North America.
Fairly accurate picture of the world and the various positions of the continents. But when we start to peel North America off the globe and transfer the curved surface to a flat surface, this is called a projection, we run into certain problems. We have to distort the image somehow. In this case, by making the northern region of the continent look larger than it is. That's been the problem for more than 400 years with the most common map, the Mercator map, named after its Belgian inventor. For example, the Soviet Union appears to be twice the size of Africa, but Africa is really about 35% larger. Other map makers tried to improve upon Mercator, but with limited success. The elliptical map, or equal area projection, was closer to reality, but the public never fully accepted it, because it looked like a peeled orange. Although no flat map is perfect, the one generally used, a modified conic projection, is as accurate as a curved surface can be shown on flat paper. If you want to describe where some place is in North America, something must be added to the globe. Lines of reference are required. One set of reference lines are the parallels of latitude, a series of imaginary lines running east and west, circling the globe. Because we're dealing with a sphere, we measure these lines in degrees. The best known parallel of latitude is the equator at 0 degrees latitude. It's the starting line. All other lines of latitude run parallel to it, equally spaced about 111 kilometers apart. The north geographic pole is 90 degrees north latitude. The south geographic pole is 90 degrees south latitude. At 23.5 degrees north latitude, is the Tropic of Cancer. At 23.5 degrees south latitude is the Tropic of Capricorn. Let's find the position of North America in terms of latitude. What line of latitude is near the southern coast at the border with South America? If you said 7 degrees north latitude, you'd be right. And at the northern tip of the continent? 83 degrees north latitude, only 7 degrees from the north geographic pole. Now, knowing the parallels of latitude won't tell you exactly where a place is located. You need a different set of reference lines running north and south, passing through both poles, the lines of longitude.
It
have the proper attitude if you knew lines of latitude run east and west. You would not be wrong if you'd remember lines of longitude run north and south.
The line of 0 degrees longitude passes through the town of Greenwich in England. Why Greenwich instead of Medicine Hat or Panama City? Simple, really. They had to start somewhere. And since the British had the most powerful naval force, since their main observatory was at Greenwich, the choice was theirs. To place North America in terms of longitude, move west from Greenwich until reaching the east coast of the continent. ...52 degrees west longitude, and then continue west, all the way to 168 degrees west longitude. From coast to coast, almost one-third of the way around the Earth. When you know latitude and longitude, you can pinpoint any place in North America, or the world for that matter. And the spaces between the lines of latitude and longitude are further subdivided into 60 lines called minutes. Havana, Cuba, for example, is located at approximately 82 degrees 15 minutes west longitude by 22 degrees 40 minutes north latitude. In fact, any place in the world, including where you now sit, can be pinpointed with a high degree of accuracy. One of the oddest things about traveling any real distance around the Earth is that if you're traveling west, and if you could fly fast enough and outrace the sun, you can get to where you're going before you start out. You can leave at noon and get there at 10 o'clock the same morning. At least, that's what the clock at your destination said. The reason for this is the whole business of time zones. As we move east and west of a vertical line that passes through, that's right, Greenwich, England, we run into a series of time zones, sometimes following the lines of longitude. They are often bent to follow provincial and state boundaries. As we travel west, we lose an hour in each zone. If it's noon in Greenwich, it will be 11, 10, 9, 8 o'clock in the morning in Maine and Nova Scotia. Why do we need time zones? Well, if it's 8 o'clock on a bright sunny morning in Nova Scotia, it is 4 hours earlier, 4 a.m., still dark in Vancouver, because the sun has not yet reached that part of the continent. When it does, Vancouver will have a bright sunny morning at 8 o'clock as well. Time zones, then, allow us to have days and nights relatively the same as everyone else. Let's put North America in perspective. The three continents, North America, South America, and Africa, seem to be about the same size, and all are shaped like triangles. But in fact, North America is bigger than South America. But not as big as Africa. Canada is slightly larger than the United States. Mexico and the Caribbean region are almost half the size of the United States.
Out of sight of the land, the ocean wide surrounds me. Far from every shore.
86% of planet Earth is covered with water. So, why didn't they call it planet water? Fair is fair.
Now let's look at North America today, not only as it looks on a map, but through the lens of a film camera.
From the frozen Arctic Ocean to the Caribbean Sea, travel across the continent, change you're bound to see. 'Cause every region's different and special in its way.
showing us the face of North America today.
The Western Cordillera. Interior plains. The Canadian Shield. Appalachians. The Atlantic and Gulf Coast lowlands. Caribbean region.
Face of North America today, yeah.